Namaste, I am Dr. Raman. I am an ENT surgeon in Manipal Hospital. I've been here as a consultant for many years. And why I'm talking to you is because our lives seem to have changed since March 25th. The way we eat, the way we entertain ourselves, the way our children are taught, the whole life has changed after this lockdown. Now we need to eat, we need to entertain ourselves, and we need to educate our children. But one of the most important thing is, how do we have access to Medicare? Apart from the viral disease which is raging the world over, common garden illnesses will be there, serious illnesses will be there, and how do we cope up with these things? How do we go and get access to Medicare so that we can maintain a healthy life? So now things are changing, and hopefully the lockdown will be lifted gradually. But life has changed for all of us. Now, to reach Medicare, we are concerned. One is, how do we get advice of the doctors? One, do we go to the hospitals where there may be infected patients and we might ourselves get infected? There may be problems of transportation. And apart from that, we do not want to ignore serious illnesses. I can assure you, the Medicare industry as a whole has taken several steps in terms of providing relief, not only for the people afflicted by the virus, but also people with common garden diseases, and also the people who might get serious illnesses like cardiac problem or stroke, etc., etc. So what we have done in Manipal Hospital is threefold. One is, we have made ourselves accessible from the confines of your home. You can get in touch with us via through video clinics, which you can book. And we, to the best of our ability, can note down your complaints and see what all we can address. Obviously, we can't address all your problems. There may be situations where you may have to come to the hospital. The next concern in your mind will be, how am I going to the hospital? Am I going to be infected? How do I get the best from the doctor without exposing myself to any danger? Well, all hospital managements have certain responsibilities. One, first one is to the patient, so that the patient doesn't acquire an infection from the hospital. Secondly, to keep its own staff, the nursing personnel, the doctors, the ancillary workers safe, so that one fine day the entire caregivers should not fall sick, and if they fall sick, we won't be able to provide enough care for you. So with that in mind, as soon as you enter the hospital, your temperature is recorded. You're also given a disinfectant so they can clean your hands, and all of us are wearing masks. Doctors are also protected with personal protective equipment, so that when they deal with any of these patients with COVID positive, they take care of themselves and they prevent the infection from spreading to the others. And if and when a COVID positive patient is taken care of by these hospitals, they are kept in an isolated area with special airflows in such a way that the airflow from that particular area does not mingle with the air conditioning inflows in the other parts of the hospital. With all these cares, you will be definitely safe. Having said that, you can definitely avoid unnecessary visits to the hospital. But on the other hand, if you have a serious problem, you need to come to the hospital and not ignore till the condition becomes bad. So we are geared up for all these things, and I want to assure you that you are in our minds, your safety is in our minds, your welfare is in our minds, your healthcare is in our minds. So with that view, we have taken all kinds of precautions so that we can give the best possible care to you. And I can assure you that you can depend on this hospital, which has been serving in Bangalore for more than 25-30 years now. You can come here and you will be given the appropriate care which you need and will be customized for you. I run the ENT department here in Manipal Hospital, so I can understand that many of you who have a sore throat, who have cough, who have breathing difficulty, who have fever, due to other reasons, might wonder whether you really have a COVID infection or you don't have a COVID infection. So you may be one, we may be one of the first people of contact when you come to us. So one of the things that we need to do is to reassure you that your illness is one of the common garden illnesses. And by the way, in case by chance you could be a possible COVID candidate, we can ask you to come to a specially established fever clinic under the guidance of an infectious diseases specialist, which screens our patients as soon as you enter the hospital to make sure that whether you need further investigations to see whether you're COVID positive or not. In other words, we segregate the patients into that group which is possibly requires more investigations for COVID, and the other group which comes to us, we reassure them and tell them not to worry, and if they have any complaints, we do take care of them. Like I said in the beginning, the virus has changed our lives, and this is not for a short period, maybe for a year, 2 years, maybe it is forever. Our thinking of hygiene, our concept of schooling, our concept of entertainment, as I said, the way we eat and go and socialize, everything is going to change. In these troubled times, what we need to do is to think positively. But at the same time, we cannot leave it to nature. We cannot wait for herd immunity to take place. We have to protect ourselves. We have to protect our family. We have to protect our community. With that in mind, please wear masks, do social distancing, and as and when there is some kind of vaccination is available, please go take those vaccinations and protect yourselves.